I can quickly work through it. Knox County Spelling Bee, we have a couple participants in there. Kindergarten projection enrollment, 24 yes, 4 not sure, so that's also a good sign. 20 would be great. It's better than 14, right? 10, things like that. 20, it's a, 20 would be a great number.
How many do we have this year? Do we know?
I'd have to look it up. I think it's very similar, but to be accurate, I'd have to look that up for you. I think it's very similar. Third quarter end of the day, here at the high school as well. Report cards to go home. NEDA is that Nebraska Educational Technology Association conference that I've taken people to over the last several years. Definitely an important part of our work that we do here, that they get out and watch sessions. You've all been to those types of things and listen to people and get ideas. This year, he has put down a couple that are going, Mrs. Stubbs and Mrs. Conant from the elementary. We also have some high school people going that I think Mr. Ostermeyer might touch on. Nebraska state tests will be given in April. You can see that those are grades 3, 4, 5, 6. And then at the high school, of course, 7, 8, and 11. Severe weather drill statewide Wednesday, March 27th. And they do that every year, too. Variety of things. Okay?
So it's the end of the third quarter already?
Yes.
Wow. Oh,
isn't that amazing?
Questions on Mr. Rogers' stuff? All right, Mr. O?
For some reason, my updated one's not on there. That's fine. I got a couple other points that I didn't
okay.
that I had changed, but it's not a big deal. Third quarter for the high school won't end until tomorrow. With the snow days, high school and trying to make sure when you have semester classes and you have quarter classes, you want to try to make those days as even as possible. So with the two snow days, we pushed it back a day, so they got a one day back for academic purposes. So ours actually in tomorrow will be the last day for term three, just due to the snow moving in. Elementary is not a big deal for them with, they don't get the credit like high school does, so that's why he just leaves it where it's at. Honor roll student of the term, we sent out next week to all the local media outlets. That'll be by March 18th, next Monday. I'll be attending the Northeast Nebraska Principals Group in Norfolk on March 13th, which is this Wednesday. They'll give us an update on some of the legislative things that are going on that could affect local schools. And also, we'll just talk about local issues that are in different schools. And one thing that's been brought up this next term is CNA. It sounds like a lot more schools looking at getting a CNA class into the high school, so I'm getting some more information on what other schools are doing for a CNA program. The letter for the parents' permission for students to leave for prom and dismissed at 1 o'clock was sent out last week on Thursday. Those are due back to the office this Wednesday, the 13th. So if students wish to be able to get out at 1 o'clock so they can get ready for prom, their parents have to sign the permission slip and turn it back in so they can leave early and make those arrangements for the many for the young ladies, the heirs, and everything else they need to get ready, so they'd like to have a little extra time for that. I'm having a meeting with Northeast Community College about the CNA class. That's Monday, March 25th. That'll also involve our nurse, Jackie Freeman will be here. That'll also involve Why Not's Superintendent Mezra Smith and their nurse, Tammy Weisler. We're looking at trying to get the CNA class done and use a couple different nurses just in case one nurse is gone or not there. Also, Jamie Miller here in town has a volunteer to help out too to make that class run. And so has Linda Jackson said she would try to help out too where she can. So it'd be nice to have a couple different nurses to go do that. Jackie does have a nurse education degree, so we can use her as our person in power school. We'll know more about that. We're not still sure if we're going through Northeast Community College or go through Avera. Avera hasn't got back to me. They were worried about coming across state line, if they can go ahead and have their class come across state lines and still do that. And so I'm gonna reach out to them this week and find out if they've figured out, you know, where they're at with that, if it's okay for them to come across state lines to use their curriculum, or if that's not gonna work. I know there's reciprocity both ways, but they weren't sure how that worked with the actual class. So I'll find out about that. I don't know if you know anything about that.
I don't know, but I know maybe they have, maybe they'll use a sim lab or something like that to meet the clinical part.
And see, what we did at the last school I was at is they, and I talked to very well already, they let us borrow a bed, let us borrow a, the stuff we needed. Yep, and then they'd have one of the students be the patient, they'd practice on the student. So they would take turns practicing on the student right here in the school with the nurse's supervision right there, you know, on watching them. That's what they did the last school I was at. I talked to Avera, and Avera sounded like either way they'd let us borrow a bed, whether we went through them or went through Northeast, because they said they would need more CNAs around here. So it sounds like they're willing to work with us, whether we use their online tech program or whether we use the Northeast program. If we use their program, it'd be high school credit only. There'd be no college credit for the class. If we did Northeast, they could get both college and high school credit. I've talked to different colleges that in the field of people who want to be nurses or doctors, and they don't really care if they have the college credit or not. They care about getting actual the CNA license. So it doesn't sound like the credit is a huge issue. So I'm just kind of weighing out what's going to be better for us and make it better for Crofton, which way we should go with that.
It's funny though that they can't bear because bear is already in Creighton. Bear owns the hospital in Creighton, so they're already across the border. I don't know how that would make.
Well, just with the education we need across the border is what they don't know at that class. And there's something they're never going to look into, and I don't know. It's, she wasn't sure. They hadn't done anything. They have a lot of Yankton students go right to the hospital and do it right there in Yankton, but they haven't had a Nebraska school ask them if they could use it in their school yet. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So I know if our students go over there, no problem. They can go over there, they can take it over there, but that would be on their own time then. It wouldn't be during, you know, for the school day. But we're trying to get it right here in the school day for them. We give them credit for it as well.
Is the way much different? Is the cost either way in Northeast or?
If they want college credit for it, it does cost, and but it's a cheaper rate because if they give them the grad, the high school rate, I don't know that I don't want to quote on what it is right now.
Curious.
If they go through Avera, then they don't have to pay for the class, but they have to pay to take the test.
Oh, makes sense.
Yeah, and that's it's kind of the same way at Northeast. You pay for the credits, but then you have to pay to take the test. And I don't know because I think it's a test like $50.
I
my wife did it a couple years ago. I can't remember. But I think it's like $50 for the test, and I don't know how much, but I know Northeast gives a pretty good discount for high school students that are going early enrollment there. And I can't tell the exact number there either.
That does make sense.
Yeah. So, and we're all sending some people to NEDA. We have Ms. Pack, obviously our education technologist. She'll be going to NEDA. Mr. Sanger with the new plasma can, he was anxious to get down there and talk to the people down there. They'll have some things that he can bounce ideas off of. Down in that world, and then Miss Leader, our band teacher, she's using that, you know, with the band this year. They all have the iPads with the music on those for pet band different things. And I think she's presenting there as well.
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay, she's not presenting there. I know she was talking about she was going to present at maybe this summer one then. So that's all I have.
Yes, despite what the weather is outside, spring sports are starting. There's about, just peek my head in there, the track, there's about 17 girls, about 26 boys that were in the gym tonight. They said the coach said there were even some that were gone. So there's a good share of kids. Boys golf, there's 12 boys out for golf this year. They are actually at the auditorium golfing. Coach DeGlau talked to the city, and the city has allowed us to utilize the city auditorium for practices rather than putting in the hallways forever, free of charge. So that was a nice thing. He checked it out, and I said, hey, if that's okay, go for it. So,
how many is that compared to last year for golf?
I want to say last year we had 8.
Oh, yeah, that many?
Yeah. So, I mean, there was, yeah, it was under 10, but this year it's not, there's too many to fit in one view. We do know that. So. Other things, FFA, obviously some of you have kids that are involved in FFA. They had their district competition about a week ago. They will be well represented at the state FFA convention, first part of April, the 3rd, 4th, and 5th. There's 10 teams that qualify, so there's quite a few kids. There's fans, and there's also a member that is qualified to participate with the state FFA choir. And then also there was one that earned outside and do some hands-on stuff with that. Instrumental music, the Mid-State Conference with Honor Band was last week. There were 16 students that participated there. All state music is toward the end of the month here. And we have two kids, Logan Leader and Sydney Tramp, that are finalists to receive a scholarship through Class C Music. So it's a very big deal for her to achieve, but she said we actually have two kids that are going to be doing that. They have district music contest coming up in April. They are only allotted a certain number of slots to fill for solos. And she said, I am over the limit as to what I can have. So she said, I'm actually having to have some tryouts for solo competition. So she's going to do that tomorrow. So she is there, going to be doing that. One other thing, speech. We had to reschedule our conference speech meet, which was to have been at the end of February because of the weather. So just this last Wednesday, they went to Wayne State, to Battle Creek. As a team, they placed third, and then they had several individuals that did very well. So we had some, the OID, I think the duet, and there was one other individual that placed first, and had some seconds and thirds. So again, did very well. Districts are on Wednesday, so they'll be going to Harrington for districts on Wednesday. So hopefully, get some kids down to Kearney and help Wayne State. So that is all I have.
Schools report. This is through January. You can see there on that chart the pounds that have been donated and then their associated costs. For instance, tonight I went and asked, is this the beef? And he says no. Because what happens is when it comes in, we use it right away. And if it happens to run out, then they have to obviously use them their beef. So you did not get to enjoy that tonight. But that is also the way it works here with us. If it's here, they're going to use it. Now they did send some in, but they were in patties. But they this last month they were all in patties, but they used them all up as well. So that's the current. So we still continue to appreciate what they do for us. And obviously continue to monitor that. So as much as they can get us, as fast as they can get it to us, we tend to eat it. So still been a very, very good thing for us. NERCSA, of course, we were talking about that a little bit, is coming up. Maybe before we leave tonight, we can just touch base to see maybe who wants to drive and discuss, because I'll have to stay down there for Class C All-State Band. So I'll have to have somebody drive one of the vehicles back, because I'll be heading back at a later time. Mrs. Dahl will follow me down on Friday. She'll come down and I'll just ride back, our vehicle, but I'll have to send the school vehicle back with somebody, so we can figure that out. We don't need to do that during everybody else's time here, but we can do that before we leave, or in the next few days, since we have a couple not here. Transition, Mr. Luck obviously is here, and we've been communicating via email and the phone occasionally, and he spent the day here. We just spent the day talking about stuff. There's obviously a lot to talk about, so kind of a free-flowing discussion, but lots of good questions and hopefully lots of good answers. And we're beginning this transition as it's a long one, but there's a lot to discuss. So we'll continue to do that, and I'll help in any way that I can, Mr. Luck. So I appreciate him making the drive today, and he's driving back tonight. Yeah, or not? Undecided. It's a long drive, but we did spend the day talking about all kinds of stuff, including. Our lunch request. Every 5 years, the school has to resubmit requests for our lunch service program. And here's a few highlights. There's been more to this, but these are some of the highlights. That FSMC that you'll see throughout, that's a food service management company. So we've advertised for that. We did have two come visit. That was on the 13th, two different companies. One was our current company, and one is another company. And then they have a couple months here where they ask questions. They ask questions of us. I have to share all the questions and the answers with both companies. It's very, very much clear with everyone what questions are being asked and the process that has to be followed. And then in April is the deadline. If they choose, to submit a proposal to be our food service management company, April 2nd. And then what happens after that is I'll need at least one board member, maybe a couple, if you'd like to. So I need to have a variety of people that look at all their information and then we score them. You score them on their options and all the things that they can do, including costs and everything else that they do. And then basically in the end of that, after they're scored, then the company that scores the best, you know, will essentially be awarded that contract. You can see that on the 12th, which is right after basically our meeting on the 11th. I think our meeting in April is on the 11th. I have to, within 10 days, notify, you know, who had received the highest score. And then I have to do a bunch of work left with the Nebraska Department of Ed and the Food Service Management Company and all that stuff in April. And then in May, the Board of Ed then finalizes that contract and votes on it and does all those sorts of things. And then that new company basically starts in July. Or it could be the same company, but or starts over, or the new company starts. So that's really a snapshot of that timeline. Lots of work with Nebraska Department of Ed regarding these things, regarding what to do, when to do it, how to do it. There are lots of rules that you have to follow, as you can imagine. I think that's all I have for you. Yes, my report. So if somebody is really chomping the bit to score food service management companies, you can let me know. You don't have to, but I definitely want to make it an option for you if you'd like to go through those. The rules don't state that a board member has to. I just thought it might be a good thing if someone might want to. And if you don't, that is also okay. So I'll commandeer.
What's that? School hours or?
It's whenever it works for us, yeah. We just basically get together and you look at all their information. So it could be any time.
Right.
And then,
I can help.
You can? Okay.
How many companies typically apply in the past?
I don't know.
Because you weren't here for that weekend.
Right.
This is the first time we've had more than one.
Okay.
There are other companies out there.
It's been one.
Okay. There are other companies out there, but
yeah.
You're saying
yeah.
They just haven't. So this
right.
time, we've got a second that I'm expecting. Thrive, I think they're called.
And using a lot of smart solutions right now.
Yeah. Right.
Depending on what's going on, I'd be happy to help too.
It's good. We just won't get over a quorum. All right, so if we have two or three or whatever it is, let me reach out. So you have the timeline there. So somewhere after that second, maybe I'll get on the phone and see where you're at and what's going on with life. And then if you're still available, then we'll figure out when we want to sit down and score them, what works best for any of us. So that works for you.
Sure. Can we look at them ahead of time, do you think, or not?
The deadline is for receiving them then. So I think we do it. I can ask that question, but
okay.
As I understand it, we have to have them in there. I don't know if we can look at them if they're ahead of time or not. That's
okay.
I'm new to this process as well.
Okay.
I'm not sure if we can.
So they give you a scorecard?
Yes. We determine on our end earlier, like what things we look at and how many points they're valued at, and then it's their job to create a packet, you know, a package of information, you know, similar to our. Air conditioning, you know, they'll send you the stuff and then you look through it and then you score it based on what you see and what you know. And then and that's basically it, and based on the scoring then you end up picking. So I'll ask if they turn them in early and we can start scoring them, I just assume that as well.
Okay, yeah.
I don't know why it would hurt, but with all the rules that go with this, I'll just have to ask. Is it?
So we have a couple services in between.
It's on the 8th, okay. Alright.
Alright, the first item of new business will be an action item to approve or approve and award the HVAC contract.
I hope.
Possible.
Again.
I hope.
That third or fourth time.
So you know where we've been. There's no reason to rehash it all. But just to recap, the most recent, we re-advertised, taking a different direction of how to obtain bids. I did get two bids. One from, I think I've shared that with you, you know, who we got bids from, one from Trane and one from Climate Systems. I'll pass those around if you'd like to see those, but you have those there's climate systems. And then this one, I'll follow you, is train. And I think I did share with you in the amounts. I did open them at a certain time on a certain day. There was a representative from train here.
Who was it?
No, it was his dad. He actually brought it up, and then it was their representative.
Okay. Hofer's dad?
Yeah. So I opened them up, you know, in front of them, because as you can do, and I basically what I did then at that point is I just read the amounts. I think the train one's at the back, or close to the back, I should say. Let me see. Oh, it's just about on the back on page 2. Oh, it's the way at the front. Pardon me. It must be the other one at the back. 695.
Climate system didn't change anything from their other proposal, right?
Right, it's that same proposal, but it's a little less in climate systems. Their amount went down a little bit. In climate systems is in the back. So there are two things we have to consider with this, and one is the company responsible, okay? And then two, the lowest. The lowest bid. So we have a clear lower bid in this case.
Substantial.
Yeah.
100 grand.
There is one difference in this. The total cost will be a little bit more because you will have an engineer cost now, which is a little bit different. But it is necessary when we take this other path that you have an engineer for any project over $100,000. So we will have an engineer cost that you will have to. And that's typically anywhere from 4 to 10%, as I'm told. I think I'm somewhere around the 4 to 5%. Actually, I think it might be a little less than 5% for the engineer. Because
they either one, we'll still have that cost.
Yes, yes. We have an engineer, no matter who we go with, that has to be in charge of that and sign off on it and do some supervising and things like that. Yes.
Didn't Climate System have the engineer built in with their bid?
Yes.
So they took that out.
Not very much of it.
I was going to say, it's not all out of there.
No, not very much of it at all. What I did do some research into that, because their bid isn't a whole lot lower.
Right.
But they had some bonding that I don't think they were accounting for on the previous route that we took. And I did some more investigating as to the bonds that they had to have. So when they do something like this, they have to have bonds. Basically, it says if they quit, if they don't pay their subcontractors, if they go out of business, the bond, it's basically insurance is going to help pay for those things. So he had to include the cost of some significant bonding in this process. And then also maybe the price of the bond a little bit, maybe. But I did talk to him about that. But some of this, he did not take out, because I want to say your bid that's on the next action item for our engineer is 20-some thousand. So yeah, that did not all come out of there. But he did have some bonds that he had to. And it's my opinion in this research that I don't even think they probably had enough bonding in the first round, meaning I don't think he had it all covered in there anyway. But that's neither here nor there at this point, Board of Ed, right? Because we're not doing it, that first round. So this is the same project that we were trying to get done in the first case. We just had to start over, right? And now you've got two bids. With the addition of the engineer, so it's going to be maybe $20,000-$25,000 more than it was. Still worth doing, in my opinion.
Do you ever call the references?
Yes.
That they have listed?
Well, no, but yes. I mean, regarding trains, yes, I know people who've used trains.
Okay.
And they,
they're all.
Yeah. I mean, the people that.
Positive,
are,
probably.
Yeah, people that have them. Yeah.
You haven't heard anything surprising from the references they have listed?
No, but regarding some of the things that happened to us, some had a similar experience with some things, but also some people on the other side, to their credit, said they worked with them and they were happy. So I think some of those things that happened with us in some certain ways have happened. You know, I even think Piercer recently, I think it's because it was a public meeting, I think they were one of the groups that were bidding on at Pierce. But they also didn't have a hard time getting numbers out of them at Pierce. So it is what it is. It is what it is.
So did we pick the engineer? So say we left the train. Did we pick the engineer? Or
yes.
The train come in and charge us?
Well, no. I have secured this engineer. Okay. He said he'd do it for us. Yeah, it would be ours. I think under that old way, that it was included in there.
Okay.
In there.
It'll be an independent of either company, basically, right?
What's that?
The engineer will be independent of either
yeah,
company.
Yeah, yeah,
I'm definitely not saying we should have a train.
Well, right. This will be pushed to get it done in August. We'll hope for the best. But at this point, I believe personally it's still worth doing. I believe that we still should do it. I would hope that the board would approve this tonight, and then they begin to move on this to hopefully get it done. It's a good project. We've been through the ringer on this. We've learned a lot, but we're finally, I believe, at this tonight would be the end. Then we have just a contract to create and sign, which our lawyers will do to make sure everything's in place.
So anywhere in here, does it say like what size chiller? Because I know we talked about that.
Yes. So what has happened this time is we had the engineer create all the specs. I did not bring those tonight. All those specifications, the size, everything needed, and that's what the company's requested. And then I sent it to them, right? So they knew exactly what they were bidding. So
did,
yeah.
Did it say just a new chiller or 180 ton?
It had every
okay.
bit of specifications in on it. Yeah, I apologize. I didn't
no,
bring those
fine.
In.
I figured.
Right. It says 130 ton. What's
I thought they were 180 because it was a sizable difference. Yeah, it gives 180. I know where I stand on it, but I'd rather get somebody else's opinion.
I think they say what size they got on this one.
No, it doesn't. But they would, so the specifications, it would be nice to know if that was 130 ton or 180 ton, just in case we'd ever add on, you know, for that back.
Just pulling up this specifications here, see if I can't find that for you.
The timing system is 180.
There is 180.
But I don't see it on there.
But when we do the contract, we specify all those things, right?
Yes.
And the way I read some of the wording in the train contract, there could be added expenses for the pneumatic controls.
Shocker.
They want to add $75,000 for that?
Well, that's right, they added.
Number 7, provide alternate price to eliminate pneumatic controls. So
on top of this?
Price for that. I'm not surprised.
Jeez, I'm going to say that's a problem.
Where does it say that?
On the map picture, line number 7.
Yeah.
If that's the way I interpret it, anyway.
Exactly.
Doesn't surprise me at all.
That could feel surprising.
What other questions anybody have? I just say if we do approve that, we need to make sure that contract has all those specifications on it.
Yes.
Because his original bid was 180 ton. I don't want it to go back to 130.
Okay.
And then the price goes up.
Engineer can clarify that, right?
Yes.
That's what he's looking for. We'll give you a little bit of time.
Oh, you want me to?
If you can, if
yeah,
it's easy.
Right.
Well, rightfully, it should have been apples to apples.
Yes. With, yes.
They
I just don't
they
know if it's 130 ton
so
or.
So, unless train didn't follow specs.
Well, they might have, but this company
right.
may have been able to go down. And its price
right.
went up. So, people that I'm curious about. Difference is between 130 and 180. I just know the 180 has got to be better. And they tried to explain it to us, and it was sizable, I thought.
Your house probably has a 3 or 4 ton.
Okay, so it's a big deal.
The difference is 50 ton.
Yeah.
Kenny, thank you for that. I appreciate that.
Who is the engineer, Corey?
What's that?
Who is the engineer?
Thanks coming up.
Yeah, next item. Good question.
Next item up is to approve the engineer contract for the HVAC project.
This is Associated Consulting. Do you need a plug-in? Are you good?
I'm good.
Okay.
I'm Rogers.
Associated Consulting is the person who did write up our previous specifications for a bid. You'll notice on here, though, his budget, he was guessing at this, that $562,000, that is not correct. But this is irrelevant at this point, because I called him and said, well, your $28,000 is fee. I said, actually, the cost of this project is going to be more than that, which his fee would have been more. And he said that's okay, just leave this. He said, this is my bid at where it's at. So it could be around $1,000-ish more. So this is around 5% of a $562,000. So actually, it's as you approved here a moment ago.
It might be less than, it won't be 5% of 581. It'll be
He said he told me on the phone, he says, this is my bid right there. But it could be more. So I was talking to him and asking him if, you know, I was trying to haggle a little bit. And he said, this is my bid here. So this is the cost. It is a necessity. We have to have an engineer for anything over $100,000. That he has been working with also. I know he's worked with Climate Systems, so they have a working relationship as well. I feel comfortable with this. We do have to have it.
Sales tax on that, will that be 4 or 5%?
We should. We're tax exempt. So I know it says it doesn't include it, but we don't have it.
Well, he just says it on here.
Right.
We'll give him a Form 13.
Yep.
Is there anything in the contract that he or she has to be on the site so many times? Or?
Not so many times, but yeah, he'll be here, as needed. There isn't any. Well, I'm sorry.
Tiana Sioux Falls also.
Yes.
Yeah.
But he will have more, he'll carry more of the weight of the supervising of this project.
And he would have done that anyways.
Yes.
So nothing's really changed.
Right.
Have you been associated with it, Corey? Do you know this person? This engineering person?
I personally don't, but I mean, other than my contacts with them. Throughout this process and knowing that they've used it in other conversations, I don't have any reason to feel like there is anything with them, you know, regarding my personal professional reaction to them, that they are not going to be able to do this project.
He was here, wasn't he?
Yes, he was here.
One of the two, the
yes.
Second one, I think he was here.
He was here on one of those presentation nights, yes.
So we have to decide whether we should accept this?
Yes. I would hope that you would do that, please.
I move to approve the engineer contract.
Oh.
The project.
Thank you.
Mr. Gitter, no.
Thank you.
Hutz?
Yes.
Van Vee?
Yes.
Langy?
Yep.
Coffey?
Yes.
Motion carried 4-0.
It'll be hot before you know.
And here we go. That's
next
good.
Action.
Thank you. That's now we're moving.
Not again.
I don't want any calls about something fell through.
Next item up for bid, I believe, is the offered teacher contracts.
Yes.
2000.
I'll pass this around for you to look at. What we're looking at specifically in this case is what I have a paper copy. Often I don't, but tonight I do. It are the items in green, because these are the certificated teachers. You'll see there's some other items there, you know, other people who are doing their extra duties, but you're not making a motion tonight on their extra duties because those are assigned by the superintendent. But it's just for your reference, and that's as they stand today. I can still change these extra duties as we move along, if that makes sense. But we're just looking at green. Those are teachers. They hold certificates. And this is something you do every year. Now, I did inform you that we're working on a plan to increase our elementary counselor time from half-time to full-time. The administrators and I have been talking about this and working on it. The plan that we have come up with to help make our half-time elementary counselor into a full-time person is we're going to have her do the elementary PE. We can do that right now. Rod Hagee does travel down to the elementary. So he takes a quarter of his day and goes to the elementary and does elementary PE. Now, why that's a good thing for us, one, as we're increasing her time, she says she would do that for us, and I think she'd be great at it. But two, that also opens up the schedule a little bit here for the high school, specifically for an advanced PE. They used to have an advanced PE here, and they used to, but then as they cut back and they went to a halftime counselor, then they had to move that person down to the elementary. So now we're able to get that back. And Mr. O knows a little bit more about that. Do you want to speak to that a little bit?
Basically, with Rod going on there, then I have to have PE either first or second block for freshmen. And because we have junior high PE, fourth block automatically has to be that way. With opening him up in the third block, then we can move some things around. First block's really tough with band and chorus and the things that are offered first block, because with other staff we share, it'll help ease some things there. We also have quite a few students who would like to take a second PE class, but maybe aren't athletes, don't want to take weight strength training. Strength training is really not their thing, but they'd like to take a advanced PE class, which would be do a lot of your lifelong things that kids may do in terms of like doing a golf, playing some volleyball, playing some tennis and things that they can maybe do throughout their life in an advanced PE for the upper grades for the sophomores through senior class. Because right now they have the freshman PE that everybody has to take, freshman PE in health, and then the only other PE we offer is strength training. And some students just aren't going to put on that route. They're not athletes. They don't see the need to, I guess, do strength training. And it's like do some physical fitness type stuff. So.
As we zoom out, you can always use more counseling time. Mental health in schools, a focus on mental health in schools, is a hot topic right now, but it is an ever-changing piece. Seemingly with students that we do get in here as well. If anything, you need more counseling time. If anything, schools are moving towards more counseling time. We're in a sense increasing her counseling time from halftime to 0.75. So from 0.5 to 0.75. To help with that as well is to have her do that PE and then opening up some free time here at the high school as well. Also, when you zoom out, I would expect to some extent maybe an ongoing difficulty to fill that position if we're continually losing an elementary counselor. Because right now I know Wayne and Pierce both have counseling positions open, and as those things start to show up, I would expect, this isn't something that our counselor has said, but I would expect our counselor to start looking at those things. And then we're forever looking for a part-time counselor, which is very difficult to do. So I think I also said in my email, we could go to one K-12 counselor. We could do that. But that's really not what's best for our kids in our district. It'd be difficult with two buildings. You're really stretched thin there. We could do that. But if you're thinking about what's best for our kids, I would say it's to just make her full-time. Now, as I was told, I think before our previous, was it full-time? Before LeVon?
Right.
It was full-time. And then
right.
When she came in, it was halftime. Is that
true? No, it was cut to halftime for that.
It was cut to halftime.
Yeah. And Rod has always been at the elementary, just one period a day.
Right. But in this case, this is
yes.
How we're saying.
So yeah, there was a full-time counselor,
right.
And then that got cut to halftime. And then.
So not necessarily going back to a full-time counselor per se, but just adding a quarter to her time in counseling, but then also helping free up some schedule with PE. I think it's a good thing for our district. It does add to our budget. I mean, you're going from a part-time person to a full-time. I mean, those are some realities. Yeah. It is.
What is counseling at the grade school? What exactly is her job responsibility?
Yeah. An elementary counselor, that's a great question. They do several things. They meet with classes on a whole, but they also do individual counseling with students. in there. There are members of, you know, the student assistance team, you know, and they do lots of parent contacts and all sorts of things as far as those things go. But they do group work, they do individual work, you know, just helping kids with the issues that they face these days is what they do.
Do you kind of track that, like how many students she sees or hours she spends with families, and has it been increasing?
Like yes.
The time that she's spending with students?
Yes, there is a need for more. But she would have that regarding who she's met with as far as data that goes. But
and not, I don't want to know who.
Nor would I share that. But yes, there's an ever-increasing need. There are more kids, basically, that she could talk to that hasn't been able to get to because of the time. Yes, it's a good thing. It's difficult to put a measurement on. Regarding, you know, you can see test scores with kids, and you can implement this and that, but mental health is a tough issue, you know, to put to a data point and things like that. But yet, numbers of kids, you know, yes, you spend more time, therefore, they're better off. But also, it's more about that thought of, you know, we could try and hang on to our halftime person for a while, but the reality is, we're gonna have a, you know, difficulty keeping someone halftime there. Which means then we can either continually try to keep them, or we can just see, you know, how can we keep them here and not have that revolving door. We could go to, you know, a K-12 person. We could. And districts do that. But I would say, on the other side, districts like in O'Neill, they have three. I think I sent that to you. Pierce, I think they have two. Wayne has two. Similar-sized schools. Now, some have one. Some have quarters, and I just don't think they're doing justice. But
personally, I think the grade school is becoming, in today's environment, the grade school counselor is probably as important or more important than the high school in today's society. You will not overwork that girl. She can take any girl you put on her.
So,
and you don't want to lose her.
In a nutshell, we would be adding a quarter for PE.
Yes. She would go from just right now a half-time counselor, 0.5. We would move her to a 0.75 elementary counselor, but also adding a quarter-time, 0.25, to PE. But the positive in that is one, we're filling that role, and we're achieving this, helping our kids, but also keeping someone who I determined would be a fantastic, long-time person here in our district, good for our kids and our school, but also then freeing up some schedules here at the high school. In other words, giving our high school kids more opportunities. But yes, the reality is, it is an added item to the budget. And that is a reality, but this isn't a horrible thing for our school and our kids.
How much will it add? So, for a first year teacher, is her title?
She's on a teacher scale. That's a good question. So she would be paid at the rate, you know, let's say if she has her master's on year one, you have a number for that. And next year it'd be master's year two. So it would essentially be off the top of my head, it would be over $20,000 that we're adding to our budget. If I'm in my head without looking, it could be someone with a master's year one, it might be in the 44-ish range.
I would say $25,000.
Yeah. And then insurance costs, you know, depending on what insurance people choose, has a different cost for our district. So to be fair, it could be a $25,000 to $30,000 right in that range. Probably more like $25,000 to $30,000 to the budget yearly.
Not incremental.
What's that?
Or incremental? $25,000 to $30,000 compared to what we're spending.
Yes, yeah, well, what we're spending today. But then as she gains, or as any teacher gains more experience, more hours, they're paid more, you know, so.
Do we have to approve that now?
What we're looking at tonight, you're looking at, there are no other changes. That's back to the green. Everyone in green there is who you're making a motion tonight to approve. But also in that discussion is whether or not you'd like me to give that contract out with that increased amount.
Anything with the union that we have to do?
No.
That's decision, though?
No.
is she aware of any of this?
Yes, absolutely. Yes. Yes.
So if we'd say yes, let's go ahead, she'd be good with it. Sounds
yes.
Like she'd have.
Absolutely, yes. Yeah, we talked with her. One, would you like this too? Would you help us with the PE? Yes and yes. I asked her point blank, are there more kids that you can see? Absolutely. And she even typed something up and sent it to me as well. So we've asked those questions, all the same questions you're asking. I asked Mr. Rogg, you talked to him about that. Absolutely, we can use more counseling help. I just wanted you to be aware that, yes, this is important and good for kids, but yes, it's adding to our budget. I wanted you to not think that this wasn't, because this is a reality.
And in the green, this is just all the teachers we currently have, or is there any that are not on here?
Yes, they're all on here. Yeah. So your motion that would be is to, I think I typed it up for you. I'll have to pull it back
and this
up.
Is based on your guys', what you guys want or need?
Yes, but specifically why we're talking about the counselor tonight, because I wanted you to know that there are changes. And before I offer another contract, that's a change that you are aware of it, because that's one of the main things that you do is offer teacher contracts. If we weren't talking about this, I would say that there are no changes to it this year. We have the same teachers. We're expecting them all back at the same level, and it would be a much quicker discussion. So tonight's a little different because I'm asking for more for our district.
And then the pink, they're just the head coaches, right?
You're right. I highlighted those in pink because as of today,
okay.
But again, those can change and may change in the course of the next few months.
You have a head volleyball coach.
Yeah. Yes. Next page. The next page. At the bottom, those are either paras or off staff members. So you'll see Bailey there is the volleyball coach, and you see Coach Lozine. He's there in basketball. So those are people that are off staff or paras. But you're not making a motion on those tonight, because those you leave to the superintendent to decide.
So a question I have, so all these coaching things, that's up to, is it you?
Or
who makes that, you guys make
that? Well, in the end, it's a team approach, because I definitely ask them their opinions on things.
Okay.
But in the end, it stops right here with that decision.
Yeah.
But I definitely do listen to and take into consideration their thoughts on things. And in the end, we may not always agree on them.
So is it your decision or is it
mine? It's mine. It falls to me.
Okay.
But I do that as an informed superintendent, as you'd expect. I ask opinions, and people have varying opinions on these sorts of things.
And nobody's going to retire this year that you know of, or when do they have to tell you about it?
Generally, this is when we'll find out.
Okay.
After contracts are offered,
oh, that's right.
Then they have a couple weeks to return them, and that's when we might find these things out.
We have a couple.
Doesn't mean they will, but we do have a couple that could.
I got no issues with anything. What's that?
Where's the ruler?
As a line. Top of the page.
So one way we find out is either if they don't turn them in, their contracts, or maybe this is the time when they are just forced to make that decision. Because if they don't turn it in by a certain date, then that is their way of. Could be their way of telling us that they're not coming back. So it may happen.
You offer the contract first. Once they sign it, then you do the extracurriculars, right?
Yeah. If we know what they are, we'll include it with their contracts.
Okay.
But they can change at any time. Their coaching is other duties as assigned. We can assign it to them, or they can say, "I'd like to," do that. Generally speaking, we try and have people who want to be there do it. But yet, in a small school, you can see on page 2 there, we have a lot of people off staff that are already head coaches. So I'm trying to keep as many people who are on staff and who are teachers in that role.
So is it an option for a teacher who has a coaching contract to sign their teaching contract but opt out of coaching?
No.
That's why I asked.
No.
Okay.
No.
Probably the same thing for others.
Yeah. They can request it,
okay.
But they can't say I'm not.
Okay.
I'm not, and push it away. That's a great question. I think this year we're going to try and get them all. in the past here, their past practice has, they've received two contracts, and I even discussed this with Dana, haven't I, several times where I've said, because they're getting their coaching contracts and it says please sign at the bottom, that they have this feeling misguided that they can say no to it. So I was after this, just listing it on their one contract, saying here are your other duties, because it really isn't I'm not going to do that this year. It's just the life of the teacher sometimes. Ideally, we want them to want to be here, but sometimes we may have to just assign it.
So do the coaches on the second page get, do they sign contracts as well at the same time?
Yes, we'll send out their coaching contracts also, yes. Yes.
Are they separate from the classified staff? They're an actual separate entity than
who's that?
The coaches.
Second page.
The extra coaches, the paras and staff.
Oh, right.
Are they considered
classified? Yes. Yes.
They are considered classified.
The paras are considered classified. The others who are off staff are just, I don't know what you call
off
it.
Staff.
Yeah, independent.
I was just curious. I remember.
They sign a contract, but yet if they decide they didn't want to come back, we don't have any recourse, right? We're a teacher, you have a certificate,
right,
that you could take away from them, which would be a bad thing.
At the second page, pretty much told you they're all coming.
Yes.
I hope so.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, we've been through a lot of those. Yes. I would say no one has said that they aren't, but we have some questions about a couple there, just because we're waiting to hear. But regarding head coaches, yeah, they're all coming back. Because depending on numbers, she may be the assistant junior high boys or the assistant or the girls junior high basketball. Just depending on who has the higher number.
Or she'll do PE if none of the kids are out for the two sports. We don't have two different PE classes going on.
So that's kind of a maybe. Kind of a, you're in that slot. Depending on where we need you most, we'll put you in there.
So is it junior high boys?
Yes.
Oh, okay. I saw girls basketball.
Junior high boys or junior high girls basketball. Yeah.
Is that National Honor Society thing going on?
It is.
Yes. Yes. 7 o'clock.
It is.
Situation in the high school is, but I think the junior high or the elementary counselors with broken families and stuff is probably more important than it's ever been.
Does St. Rose have a grade school counselor?
No. We also, in part of our research, asked and reached out to them to see if they would be willing to, and they said they wouldn't at this time.
Okay.
Because we used that avenue to say, okay, hey, could you use this? And the answer this time was no. We do share our music with St. Rose, as you know. So we did travel down that path as well.
If the high school counselor would need to take like a FML for some reason, would the elementary school counselor help fill in, or would we find someone else to step in for a spot, just say hypothetically she'd need a
certified the same?
Yeah. Could they transfer back and forth? Could
yeah,
they share?
They could help, yes. Yeah, they could.
Last time we had, he was on maternity leave. Then, basically, we saw him this week. We picked it up. Like, I helped out, make sure scholarships, she needed deadlines. I had to step in and do some of that stuff. It's just hard to find somebody who knows counseling well enough to get a sub to do counseling.
Yeah.
So, obviously, we had a sub for her classes, her one class. information and stuff ready. She had, nice thing, she has Google Docs. She sent them to me, and I'd make sure I picked up the Slack to make sure we had things to go. Because she, because it didn't really hear, was that 2 years ago? It's been 2 years now, hasn't it? Or last year? Just last year, okay. Can't remember what it was. Okay, so a year, yeah, last year for the year, she was on maternity leave at the end, so we had to, finish sending things off to colleges for seniors and different things. And,
but yes, to answer your question, thank you.
What do you estimate her incremental cost investment for next year? Is it 25 to 30? Let's assume if she's half time, what's the base for teachers is like 36. So I'm assuming she's at 18 to 25.
Yeah, she has her. She'll have her master's. So she's a little farther over. I can pull that up.
Yeah, because.
Next year,
pretty much double whatever that base is.
Yeah, it'll
and
go.
And the benefits will go up somewhat.
Right, so someone this year, year one with a master's is 40, for next year, would be 41,000. Year two with a master's is 43,000. So you could estimate about half of that this year. So again, around.
Plus
I think that 25 to 30,000 is going to be a fair, fair estimate.
And was it's last year that we added Mrs. Pack, right? The technology.
We did. Yes. Yes, last year we added our instructional technologist, and she's 75% instructional technology and 25% special ed.
Is she coming back next year?
I think he's on the right, but she's not.
Okay.
Yeah, I've heard nothing.
I've heard all good things about her.
That's good. That's good. I'd like to think we hire good people.
So I don't know how the finances work out, but is it an option to do a three-quarter time this next year, the following year, do a full-time, or is that just a slap in the face?
We could do anything, truthfully. There isn't, we could do anything.
I have no clue how the budgeting works.
Would that keep her here, though?
That's hard to say. Truthfully, is.
From a teacher standpoint, and this isn't her telling me anything, I'm just looking at it, this is. I'm a math guy, so looking at the numbers. If you're only a half-time teacher, you only get half a year of retirement and half a year of contract, I believe, right? So that's only gives you 1 year towards retirement, so it takes you forever to actually get to the rule of 85. So otherwise, a normal teacher would get a year of experience, plus they would get get a year older, I guess, they get that living a full year, so they get 2 years. As if you're a half-time teacher, you can get a year older, so you get 1 year towards the rule 85, and only get half a year towards the other ones, you're going to get 1.5. So you only have to get 1.5 this year, only get 1.5 next year, then you're only going up to 3. If you're a full-time teacher, then you'd have 4. So you just keep losing years getting under that rule of 85 to get to retirement. You can never get there. I think for now it's 87, actually, for teachers. Rule of 87, so your age plus your number of years has to reach 87. It used to be 85 when I got in, then she got in. Last couple years.
Maybe. It's still 85.
Oh, it's still 85? Okay, I thought they moved it up. I know they had talked about it. Okay. It's still 85 then. But when you're only getting that half a year, it's just, and you're getting half benefits, so your insurance isn't, you're getting full family insurance, you're not getting, you know, other things you get with that. And other districts around will offer you that. That's why half-time positions don't usually stay forever. In this situation where it's
benefits work at three quarter. Do they stay at half or do they stay at full?
Sorry.
the school, do we, can you show, do you have data to show that, like, 5 years ago, the counselor saw 20 students, and 4 years ago, it, you know, was there an increase in the number of students, even though maybe it's hard because she says there's more students, but she doesn't have time to see them? I don't know. It'd be nice
I'd like to see
to
the before and after.
Yeah.
So what's happening today? We've made full-time. What is her schedule going to be? How many kids does she touch, you know, in the new world? Because...
And I get that she's an she's awesome.
But if we make it full-time, she leaves next year. Now we get a full-time. We're trying to find an awesome...
Yeah.
You look at mental health and education has gone up dramatically in the last 10 years, and with the internet and with social media and with kids younger and younger being access to things and parents not being home and stuff, there's so much more things going on mentally that there is a need to intervene at younger and younger ages, unfortunately, with kids. And we didn't have that before. And they didn't have all the access. It was PBS after school, and that's all you got because there wasn't much cable. There wasn't a lot of the other things. But now it's just a... Unfortunately, that's a huge hot topic right now, and education is that mental aspect of it.
Is it an action that we have to vote on for you to do it? I guess I'd love to see more data.
Yes, we can.
Or what our schedule looks like today, what it would like.
You can move to offer contracts as they were, and then we can continue to study this, and it could still be offered at a later time.
Even if it is a month.
Yeah, absolutely.
If that fits the time.
If that helps think and helps, if we can gather some of that data. With LaVon being gone, I'm not sure how we produce some of that, but we can certainly try.
I'm all for it. I think it's the right thing to do, the 25 to 30,000.
Right. So, hearing, if I may, Mr. President, hearing what you're saying, that we can offer contracts as they are this year, without adding this extra time, and then we can study that, and you can still change that and offer that, increase that the following month.
And that would still fit all the timelines? If we did it next month, we'd still be okay for you?
Because they can choose to sign or not sign it, we could always increase it.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah, I don't have a comment. I just don't know how much data you're going to be able to come up with.
Well, we can certainly try, though. If nothing else, we can say how many visited this year and how many potentially more
have her put something together.
Absolutely.
All right.
I'm not sure exactly what her regular work looks like.
Right.
You know? Right.
That's fair.
If I'm all for it, just I'd like a little more data before we approve.
Okay.
All these other ones I'm okay with.
So I think with that, I think the motion then would be is just to offer teaching contracts. As discussed, and we know what that means. As far as discussed, I will just proceed with as it sits now, and then we'll gather some more data. So we'll still offer those at the current levels, basically.
Also move to offer contracts as discussed.
I'll second it.
Discovered here, I'll show you a picture here. It's a large picture, so maybe it's going to load slowly. Well, which is fitting because we're talking about wireless. We have good speed here. Okay, here we go. What you're looking at here is, and of course, when these were installed into the high school, at the time they're installed, there wasn't a lot that was known about wireless. And this is where you'll find them in a typical classroom, beneath a desk, in front of chairs. And I drew some arrows there because that signal is bouncing off those chairs and bouncing off the desk. So what we want to do is rewire from back here, clear the classroom, and the best location for wireless is if this were our classroom, it'd be right in the middle, in the ceiling. And then let me show you another picture here, and that would look something more like that. Forgive my rude crude drawing there, it'd be in the middle and it's shooting down. So we can increase our speed and do a better job as we're moving into one-to-one. It is functional the way we have it, but what we want to do is use some E-rate funds. Now, part of my proposal is we have access to funds that are called E-rate funds. And what that means is around 60% of this cost, this is one of those things where you have to spend it to get it, if that makes sense. This E-rate funding is out there for schools to utilize if you use it. But if you don't take advantage of their offer, and they limit it to certain things technology-wise, one of those things is rewiring. So they say if you want to give your kids better access or increase, you know, their internet, you can use this money. And if you don't use it, it's just gone, kind of thing. So I've crossed this off there. It's not going to be $13,500. It's going to be more like $11,000. And the reason why I crossed that off here is because one of the items on here we said we didn't need. This item here, it's $1,900. Also, these things here, without getting too techy on you, are switches. We don't know if we need four, so we may knock off around another $800 of this. And then whatever our total is, I just took the $2,000 off of there. It'd be an estimated this. E-rate, if it is funded, because we're jumping through the hoops, would cover 60% of that. So our cost is $4,600. To me, this is an easy no-brainer. They're willing to cover 60% of this. It makes it better for our kids here at the high school to relocate our wireless to be better in our rooms.
Would it be in every room?
Yeah, all the rooms.
So every room would have that little...
Well, they have them now, but they're hidden. They're buried because when they came in back then, they just went off the old drops. They put them there. People didn't know as much as they knew now.
So they would it still be the same tool?
It's the same tool.
Just rewiring it to a different location.
You're exactly right. The same tool, that same device, just rewired and put up here to where it shoots down. And then it's therefore better and faster for our kids. This is a really good summer project. E-rate may go away. This isn't the sky is falling tale. The E-rate is there some years it's not. It may go away, it may not. It's one of those things that they offer and that we can utilize, but to take advantage of that decreased cost is significant. And it's important for us. So $4,000 isn't much in the scheme of things. It's a summer project.
So does our megabyte stay the same?
Yes. Yes.
It just increases speed.
Well, we're not really increasing the speed per se. Let me go back to that picture. Is we're just moving the location of it, so therefore it'll be better because this is where it's at now.
Looks to me like it run into.
Well, it's just down there, and it's got all these things in there. So when it's in the middle here, it doesn't have anything, you know, to get in its way. It's just faster.
How's the speed been overall with the students? I can't say something.
You can tell when there's a lot of teachers using it at certain periods. You know, you can tell when they're being used. I'm a little nervous for state testing. If we have too many groups trying to test at the same time, because during MAPS testing, when we try to do that, we can have a little bit of interference to begin with. That's got better with some things. Some of it was just how the things were tuned up and turned up, and we had to readjust a little bit so they weren't bouncing off each other and confusing the machines. Which has been a lot better. This would help out even more.
This would help.
They're not going, horizontally. They'd be going just down vertically, which would be a lot better because they won't be interacting with each other as much.
This will help with speed.
Yeah. So I think we're at 200 now, right here.
Yeah.
And if we went to 300, it wouldn't change anything. They can do that.
This location would still be bad, and it would still be right. Better to move these. But we
but
can.
I mean,
go
we can upgrade and still use all these.
Yes.
Yes.
I think it's a no-brainer, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do it.
This is a similar process to all the other. We've been really good at sending out bids between air conditioning, our kitchen, and now this. We had to send out bids. We had to advertise. And then we had one who's done some work in the area. They're going to do Laurel as well. They're from, I want to say, it's Scott's Bluff or somewhere clear out there.
I saw
McCook. But they're a
no brainer to me.
Yeah.
I'm moved to
So I suppose you know before time to receive the funding, correct?
Yes, this is all if I wrote in the motion to approve the wiring upgrade if E-rate funding is approved.
Oh, okay.
Right? So if it's not approved, we don't do this. And they also know this.
Okay.
They know that if we don't get it, they're not going to get the job.
Hate to do it, oh, we don't get funding.
Right, right. This is contingent upon funding. Great question.
Very well said.
That the Board of Ed vote on the selling of any district property. We have an old vertical mill that hasn't been used for years and years and years, and with our plasma table and some other things, we're asking that we sell that for around $300. It's, we do have someone who's interested in it, and this is purely a policy thing that we, before selling something, we talk to the board about it. It's a safety net for the board and taxpayers to not just start unloading things and not telling people about it. So it's a vertical mill. We're asking $300 for it. Unless you have any questions about it. Yeah.
I'll still move.
I'll second it. Poppy?
Can I abstain for a moment? We'll be the ones purchasing it, so I'd like to stay.
Oh, okay, right. Yeah,
we only need three votes.
Yeah, you need a two-thirds majority, and tonight, since we have four, three out of four will do it.
I'm not sure it's an option.
I'll charge 400. Yes, yes.
Van Heek?
Yes.
Langy?
Yep.
Motion carried 3-0.
Meeting in April, Monday, April 8th. Anybody got anything on that date, or I can make any time work?
I actually have a conflict with that, but
okay. Earlier or later, we'll get you out of that.
I'm out of town on the 8th, all day on the 8th, but
that's okay.
Yeah.
That's okay. I mean,
yeah.
As long as we have a call.
Yeah.
How about you guys? I'm Roger, but later or earlier, that plan very nice.
That's for you.
What works best for everybody else?
I'm at your leisure. Whenever you said it, Mr. President.
7 o'clock, that ain't too late.
That worked for me.
Seven.
I really like 7 to 6.
Okay. 7 o'clock on the 8th.
Yes.